गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, एंड आई एम टेकिंग रिविजन फ्रॉम चैप्टर 3 एंड नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर इज़ द फाइबर टू फैब्रिक एंड आई टोल्ड यू अबाउट द कॉटन फाइबर एंड नाउ आई विल टेल यू द वॉट इज़ द जूट. सो जूट इज़ अ प्लांट फाइबर. वी नो दैट जूट इज़ अ प्लांट फाइबर एंड ऑब्टेन फ्रॉम द स्टेम ऑफ प्लांट दैट इज़ कॉल्ड द पैटसन. And in India, jute is mainly grown in the West Bengal, Assam and some parts of Bihar. And it grows very well in alluvial soil of the regions of rivers such as Gangas and Brahmaputra. This best soil is the alluvial soils. And jute is sown during the rainy season. And its plant is 8 to 10 feet high and it bears yellow flowers and when it is 3 to 4 months old, when the flowering takes place, the jute plant is cut, and it is because good quality jute is obtained from its stem only at this stage, as otherwise stem gets very hard and it is difficult to remove fiber from it. And the cut plants are allowed to dry it in the fields for a few days, and when most of the leaves dry and fall off, and then the dried plants are then tied into the small bundles and made to sink in the stagnant water, and after that it is kept there for few days, and after that during this sinkage the gummy substances holding the jute fiber to the stem rots, and this process is called the retting. And the jute fibers are extracted from the retted jute by jerks and pulls of hands. The jute fibers so obtained dried and tied into small bundles, and then the raw jute fibers are silky pale yellow in color and 6 to 8 feet long, and they are quite strong and can be easily spun to form threads, yarn of different thickness. And spinning of cotton yarn. Before we learnt about spinning, let us perform the following activity to understand why spinning is necessary. So activity 5, hold some cotton in your right hand and pinch it between the thumb and the forefinger of the left hand and gently pull outward, twisting in clockwise direction till you get a wick about 20 cm in length. Divide the wick into two parts. Keep one part of the wick as it is and twist the other part of the wick as much as you can so as to make a thread. And hold the first part of the wick untwisted from both ends and then try to pull it apart. Repeat the procedure with twisted thread, and you will notice that twisted thread requires more force to break compared to the untwisted wick. Thus the activity clearly proves that twisting increases the strength of the fiber. Activity 5, you can see this. So we can say that twisting increases the strength of the yarn. And then spinning. What is the spinning process? The process of twisting the fiber so as to make a stronger thread is called spinning. And during spinning, the fibers from the mass of cotton are drawn outward and at the same time twisted to form a strong yarn. and common spinning devices. What is the common spinning devices? In remote villages in India, the ling, deseeded cotton, is beaten to shreds to form fluffy mass, and this fluffy mass of cotton is then made into loose cotton wicks about 1 cm thick and 15 cm long, and the cotton wick are then converted into cotton yarn as described below. That is the atakli or a hand spindle. Atakli or a hand spindle. It is a tapering 15 cm to 20 cm long steel or brass rod having a sharp depression, depression A near the top, and then you can see that a steel or brass disc is attached near the bottom, and the cotton wick is twisted to form a small thread which is then hooked at A, and then the takli is suspended vertically and is given a sharp twist in clockwise or anti-clockwise direction so that it starts spinning, and at the same time the cotton wick is pulled outward and the fibers from cotton are drawn and the same time twisted to form cotton yarn, and the cotton yarn so formed is removed from A and wound over disc B, and this process is repeated on and on when a roll of cotton yarn is formed on B. So this is the takli or charkha you can see here, and then a charkha or a spinning wheel. Next one is the a charkha or a spinning wheel. So it is a mechanical device. It is a mechanical device in which a sharp spindle of steel is made or to rotate very rapidly with the help of a hand wheel, and then the cotton wick is twisted to form a small thread which is wound over the spindle, and the spindle is then made to rotate rapidly by the hand wheel, and then at the same time the cotton wick is gently pulled outward, and then the fibers from the cotton mass in cotton wick are drawn out in the form of threads, and which is at the same time twisted to form cotton yarn. The cotton yarn is wound over the spindle, and the process is repeated on and on till a roll of cotton yarn is formed. And use of charkha was popularized by the father of our nation, Mahatma Gandhi, as a part of independence movement, and he advised people not to wear imported cotton cloth made in the mills of Great Britain. Instead, he advised people to wear cotton cloths made from homespun cotton, commonly called khadi. And now industrial spinning of cotton. Industrial spinning of cotton. In industrial mills, the raw cotton, lint, raw cotton is called the lint, is carded, beaten to shreds to form fluffy mass, and cleaned from straw and dry leaves, etc. And the clean cotton is then fed into a machine in which the fibers are combed and straightened. Then it is then finally converted into rope-like strands in another machine. And this rope-like strands of cotton fiber is called silver. To make silver into a stronger yarn for weaving, it is pulled and spun in another machine, and the cotton yarn, commonly called the thread, is wound on big wooden or plastic reels called the bobbins. Then it is reeled into the bobbins, and the yarn on the bobbins is finally used for weaving cloth. So here different processes are there, which type of common devices are used for spinning and all. And then you can see that yarn to fabric. There are many ways by which fabrics are made from the yarn. However, two main processes are knitting and weaving. Two main processes are there, that is the knitting and weaving. Knitting is a method by which a single thread और यार्न में बी टर्न्ड इनटू क्लॉथ विद द हेल्प ऑफ हैंड और मशीन. एंड यू मस्ट हैव सीन योर मदर निटिंग स्वेटर और मफलर एट होम प्रॉपरली. यू कैन सी इन निटिंग अ सिंगल थ्रेड इज वेवन विद द हेल्प ऑफ टू निटिंग नीडल्स एंड टू फॉर्म ए डिस्क्राइब शेप ऑफ एन आर्टिकल रिक्वायर्ड. एंड इफ यू पुल अ थ्रेड फ्रॉम द निटेड आर्टिकल इट गेट्स पुल्ड आउट कंटिन्यूअसली टिल द आर्टिकल गेट unraveled. And these days most of the knitting is done with the help of machines. This time of knitting is mostly done with the machine. And the garments such as vests, underwears, sport shirts, sweaters, muffler, socks, caps, etc. are made by knitting the yarn of cotton or wool. And weaving. What is the weaving? The process arranging two sets of yarn together to make a fabric with the help of a hand loom or power loom is called the weaving. What is the weaving? The process of arranging two sets of yarn together to make a fabric with the help of a hand loom or loom, this is called the weaving. And in a villages, cotton and wool are made on a small scale by the weavers using hand looms. And then on a large scale, cotton and woolen fabrics are made by big machines which run on electricity. And these machines are commonly called the power looms. In any kind of loom, the yarn placed lengthwise on the frames is called the wrap. Another yarn is wound on wooden reel and is placed in the shuttle of the machine. And this machine is carries thread in the shuttle back and then across the wrap lengthwise yarn, and the yarn which the shuttle spreads across the wrap is called the weft. During weaving, the weft threads cross over and use the under the wrap thread alternately and make the fabric. So this is the chapter 3 is not completed, and what I taught today you will take revision, you will read.